Or as the Canadians say, my parcel. Sounds so fancy. Good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday. It's cold. It's 9 degrees. I think the feels like is like -5 or something, but it's not windy. So there's that. But I know that it's cold everywhere. Well, most everywhere. Some of you, it's not. Well, maybe it's cold for where you're at. Maybe that it's that. But anyway, today is Wednesday for me. It's Thursday for you. I have to go to the post office to drop off some boxes. You can see my IKEA bags. Also, that's my tip of the day. If you go to the post office a lot and you have not invested in IKEA bags, you can order them on Amazon. Did you know that? Did you know that you can order IKEA bags in bulk on Amazon? Well, you can, and I highly recommend it because I don't know what I'd do without my IKEA bags. They're my best friend, and that and my Rollo are my best friend in my reselling business. Anyway, then I have to go to the UPS store because if I try to give my customers the cheapest shipping possibilities, and sometimes depending on where my boxes are going, UPS is far cheaper. So it does, I do have to go one more little step out of my way. Typically though, sometimes I say if I have to, and if I talk to you on the daily, you already know this because I get excited, but typically if I have to go over to the UPS store, I reward myself with a donut from the bakery. I did that yesterday, so I'm not going to do that today. That was just a yesterday thing. So I'm not going to get a donut today, but I am going to go to the UPS store. So, and then I have to pull a few eBay sales that happened overnight. Well, I had two sales. One of them hasn't paid yet. So hopefully by the time I get there, they have paid. And then we're going to go over my what sold on eBay. I haven't even looked to see what my numbers were. It was a much slower week for me. Again, I sell on eBay part-time. I'm a full-time reseller, but I'm a part-time eBay seller. And I haven't really listed. I've had a lot of live sales lately, and I haven't really listed a whole lot on eBay. So I'm trying to do at least three new listings a day. That hasn't happened. So my sales haven't been the greatest. But I am clearing some stuff out, which is really what I wanted to do. So, and then I have a live sale today. You will have seen that yesterday if you watch my live sales, but that's going to happen today for me today with Vintage Vinny. So I have everything ready for that. I am going to create a reel on Instagram. I might talk about that a little bit. I'm not real. I do the bare minimum on my reels. I know that there's a lot more you can do, but I don't understand it fully. I just do what I know. Anyway, let's go ahead and go. Let's go to the post office. Let's go to the UPS store. Let's go to the shop and let's get this day started. Let's go. All right, we are at the post office now. And I just want to say, I have the best post office in the entire world. The Bedford, Indiana post office and the Bedford, Indiana postal workers are the top-notch postal workers in all of the land. I'm just going to say that. I cannot tell you how gracious and how helpful they are. So another tip of advice I'm going to do two today. Well, I probably will do a couple more, but this is the other one. And this is a really, really important one and more important than the IKEA bags, but talk to your postal workers. If you are going to your post office every single day, talk to your postal workers. Be gracious with them. Be thankful for them. If they are so wonderful in helping you out in your business, it's such a good relationship to have. I sometimes I'm going to the front lobby today because I only have two IKEA bags, but they know me. They're like, we'll have a buggy ready for me. They're lovely. So Post Office Appreciation Day is coming up very soon. I'll put that down there. So think of your post. They are federal employees. They can't accept like gifts that are, you know, but maybe just telling them thank you and appreciating them in that way would be a great thing. I know that sometimes they get a bad rap because like, oh, the post office broke my items, but you know, they do the best that they can. And say thank you. Just be gracious. So I'm that's something that I'm consciously, that's the way you say it, right? Thinking of, but I'll post the dates down there of when Post Office Appreciation Day is. So let's go in and let's get these packages taken in to our lovely postal workers. And then I'm going to check my P.O. box as well.
IKEA bags for the win. They're the best.
Back in the car now. I'm sorry, this is a lot of me just talking in the car right now. I promise we're going to get to the meat of the video. But I'm so excited. I got a parcel from Canada. Oh, Canada. But it's from a viewer that told me that they were going to send me some Canadian snacks. So we'll have to open that up today. Thank you so much. All right. UPS store and then to the shop. And we're going to open up our box, see what's inside, and then pull the eBay. We got some stuff to do before we get to the shop. That's basically what I'm trying to say. But let's go. All right. We're here. I am so full of static after having my hat on, but we're at the shop. I'm going to go ahead and get my computer set up and stuff, but then we're going to open up this box and see what's inside. So let's get I'm going to make my coffee first. I bought a Keurig that I keep here at the shop, and this saves me from going to Starbucks. This is the coffee. It's upside down. I'm sorry, but it's Crave Coffee. It is so good. You can get it on Amazon. I think I got this big box for like, I don't know, maybe $30. I'm not like the cinnamons. I don't think I'm not a cinnamon person, but there are caramel, French vanilla, Vermont maple. My favorite is the blueberry and raspberry. Oh, we're going to have wild raspberry today. Yum. Apparently, it's made in New Jersey, but yum, yum for the Crave coffee. You just went for a ride. So, I got my box here. I opened it up, or as the Canadians say, my parcel. Sounds so fancy. All right, so we're going to turn the camera down so we can see what's inside. Open it up. Oh, there's a note. There's a note. Let me see. Let me take the note off. Oh, my goodness. Misty, I hope that you enjoy your ketchup treats. Oh, look at this box. She put little butterfly stickers up there all over it. That's so cute. I hope you enjoy your ketchup treats. I've included a few pieces of vintage porcelain for you. The brooch isn't old, but so pretty. Your northern neighbor, Cindy. Stay safe. The pen and the notebook are made especially for you. Look at, this is lovely. Look at, oh, it's so pretty. I don't want to mess it up. I'm going to save these flowers, Cindy. Cindy, I'm saving your flowers. Okay. Oh my gosh, Old Dutch. They're the best. Oh my gosh. Okay, these are my favorite brand. The Old Dutch ketchup potato chips. Yum. And you know what? I'm all out. So Cindy, you just stocked me back up. Wait, what is this? This is different. This says Baked Cuties 04. Owl 4. Is this... This is the Canadian or the French version, maybe? I don't know. What's this? Crisp? Oh, look, we can be on a diet. This is diet ketchup stuff. Crispy Minis ketchup. Gluten-free. Yum. Brown rice cakes. Rice cakes ketchup flavor. That's interesting. Okay. Oh, this must be the brooch. How is this camera angle? Probably not that great. There we go. Well, you know, when you're on this tripod, you go for a little ride sometimes. Oh, it's wrapped in this beautiful hanky. Oh, lovely. Uh-oh. Did it? Oh, no, it broke. You know what? We'll fix it. I will fix it. I've got some glue that will fix this. Oh, it is lovely though. Oh, I'm so sorry, Cindy, but we'll fix it. We'll get it as good as new. All right, and then it's wrapped up so lovely. I'm saving all these little things. I'll reuse them. I will. Oh my goodness.
Oh, Cindy, did you make this? I'm assuming that you did. All right, let's unwrap it so we can get a closer look. Oh my gosh, it's lovely. Enjoy the life. I love that. This is great because sometimes I'll write down what eBay orders I have to go pull from my shelf. So this is a perfect size for that. Or honestly, this is great to keep in my car. Oh, and the pen too. Oh, that's so, and it's so sparkly. It matches my nails. But I can keep this in my car to keep track of like things that I would get, oops, at a yard sale this summer, you know. That's a good idea too. I might keep that in my glove box in my car. Oh my goodness. Now we've got Humpty, oh my gosh, Ringlows. Now we might be a little too close. Ringlows, Humpty Dumpty, more ketchup treats. Lay's ketchup. They sold these for a limited time in the US a couple years ago. Oh my gosh. Pringles ketchup chips. I'm so sorry about the angle. Oh my gosh. This is like Christmas. Ruffles double crunch. Ultra croquants. I don't know. That's French. That's fancy. Oh my gosh. Look, I got a stack of ketchup treats. All right. I think that's just filler. All right, so what else we got? Oh, another little cute little hanky. Oh, how cute. A little egg cup. A little egg cup. Another beautiful little hanky. Very cute for spring. Oh, this twofer. There's two hankies in here. Oh my goodness. It's a pie bird. Oh, how cute. A little crow pie bird. Oh, so cute. I think that's just filler too, but we'll reuse that. We'll reuse that paper. And then, oh, some teas. You know, tea is something that I always think that I want to try, but I've never really tried it. But oh my gosh, cookies and cream tea, pumpkin spice tea. I'll definitely take these home. I would like to try some tea. So there you go, Cindy. You've made it easy for me. All right, this is the last thing. In this, wrapped in this beautiful vintage linen. Oh, how lovely. These are made in Japan. They are wall pockets because they have these nails, so you could hang them on the wall, but you could also just set them up. These will be lovely for a spring display. Thank you, Cindy. Thank you, Cindy. That was so nice of you. Oh my gosh. You know what? This box was even great too because I needed a box with a lid that I could use to take back and forth when I have my Sunday sales. So I'll even reuse your box, Cindy. Thank you so much. Yeah, I love my ketchup chips, but you stocked me up, girl. You've stocked me up. Thank you so, so much. Okay, so now I'm going to clean up this mess. I'm going to put all these little things of tissue paper and bubble wrap in my recycle bin that I will use on other packages. And then we're going to go over here and do a little bit of an Instagram reel for my sale today. So I'm going to do that real quick. If you are doing live sales, or if you just are even selling in an antique booth, it's very important that you utilize social media to help generate some business to people, and use those hashtag, like hashtag Indiana Antiques, or hashtag, you know, my antique mall, whatever your antique mall name is. Do a hashtag and it will show up in other people's feeds. That way they'll be like, what's this place? This is a great place. I need to go check that out. So utilize those hashtags. You make the reels. It's really important that you at least post one post and one reel on Instagram every day. Some of us do a little bit more than that, but it's just a fun way that you can promote your business. So I highly recommend that you get on that and use whatever social media platform that you would like. I use Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. So, all right, let's make our reel. And then we're going to get into what sold on eBay. Now we're going to walk over to where I store my eBay. Again, I'm a part-time eBay seller. This is all of the listed things that I have on eBay right now. My eBay store is linked down in the description if you want to go and check it out. It's, you know, it's some vintage, some mainly like a lot of vintage toys. And I do some beauty products. Things that I purchase in subscription boxes, and then things that I don't use. Let's see. Oh gosh, I'm gonna have to look and see what it is I'm looking for. There she is. This is full set. Some kind of, oh, there you are. That. That's what it is. It's some sort of a, I think a moisturizer. So that is the only thing. I did sell a vintage toy. I'm going to go ahead and pull it. They haven't paid yet, but I'm going to go ahead and set it over here next to me for when they do. And it is He-Man. He-Man. No, it wasn't He-Man. Was it He-Man? Oh, good grief. Hang on. Oh, it's me. I'm back. It wasn't He-Man. It was, oh, y'all remember John Blackstar? Remember that was the whole discussion last week? Well, his nemesis sold. His chest glows. Well, his chest glows. He's John Blackstar's nemesis. He sold as well, and we'll talk about what these things sold for when we get into what everything else sold for this week, but just these two things sold overnight, so I'm going to get these two things packaged up. All right, so we've got Mr. Man over here, and then I already have him in a bag, and then I'm going to go ahead and stick this moisturizer in another baggie just to protect it from moisture. I'm going to go ahead and just stick my card in to this guy here. I'm going to go out on a hunch and think that the person that is buying this little guy here isn't necessarily going to care much that I put tulle and stuff around him. So we're just going to stick him. I have these boxes that my husband gets from work, which is awesome. They have a foam insert. So that's all I'm going to use on him. And the boxes themselves are, they're a little thin. So I'm going to go ahead and put them into a poly bag. These fun with the pizzas on it. This is packet chic, and I know I've had these for a while. I'm not sure if they still have this design or not. So we're gonna get this weighed. It is 5.6 ounces, so we're gonna round that up to 6. I know that this is a 10 by 10. This is I'm gonna put villain. That'll help me. I do will sometimes write down on the boxes what it is. So, and then I just put the label right over that. So we're going to go ahead. That is done. I think I'm going to go ahead and stick this in a box as well. This is a beauty product item. So I'm going to make it a little bit prettier. And I'm just going to put some tulle around it. Like it doesn't take much just to make it just look a little pretty. I like to do it. It's not something that you have to do. Put my card, and then you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna recycle one of Susan's flowers that was on her package that she sent me. We're gonna tuck that on there. Let me use another one of these boxes. Hopefully it'll fit. Should. We're going to put it in this poly bag, so even if it's a little bulbous, that's okay. It's a really good idea to have all of your items on hand, you know, around you, and make you go a lot quicker. Well, it'd be nice if my scale would stay on for a little bit longer instead of timing out, but can't have everything. So this is 6 ounces right on the dot. This is
is also 10 by 10. And I already know that this is the opposite of the other thing that I sold. So I'm not going to ride on it. Ooh, my goodness, you went for a ride. I'm so sorry. So, all right. So I'm going to go ahead and get these labels printed for these two items. And then we will get into the what sold on eBay. So let's go do that now. All right, guys. My eBay app is just not cooperating very well with me. So some of these may be repeats from last week, and my whole like end of the week numbers thing is messed up. So bear with me. If I repeat something, I'm sorry. I'm not sure what's going on. So I've tried to do this the best that I can. Like I said, I didn't sell as many things this past week because I didn't list a lot of things this past week, and you have to list things in order to sell things. So these are the things that I did sell. The first thing is this little slot car. My husband loves his cars, and this is kind of his thing, but it is a slot car made by Tyco, Tomy, Life, Like, or I don't even know what all these means, but he created this listing. We do free shipping on these. They do ship first class. He sold it for $25. With a best offer accepted. Probably we had this listed for 28 and took a best offer of 25. But you can see here the condition is, I guess, pretty good. And then I guess you can take the top of it off to see like the mechanicals on the inside. So I'm not even sure where we even got these. He buys these things sometimes at flea markets, at yard sales. Probably did not pay hardly anything for it. There is quite a market for these Hot Wheel cars. So if you have some Hot Wheels, especially the red lines will be like a little, there'll be like a little red line all the way around the tire. Look them up. When you flip them over, a lot of times they'll have a date on them and even the make of the car. You might be surprised at some of what some could sell for. All right. So that's almost $25. The next item is this guy. Boy, he's frightening. He has a lot of wear on his chest. He was from 1993, Bandai. He's one of the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, Putty Patrol. He's evil. He's an evil alien, apparently. This also shipped first class and sold for $15.99. And I probably got him in an auction lot at a yard sale in a baggie of other things. I don't know. I don't think that I, or maybe Mark bought him because he sometimes looks out for these kinds of things when we're shopping. Oh my gosh. This I got at an auction and I think I paid a dollar for it. I had it for a while. I did end up changing it to free shipping. You can see it was sealed. It's from the 70s. It's this photo plaque where you could hang all these photos on your wall. Still sealed in the package. But the package had some wear to it. It sold for, $15. I did do free shipping. It did ship first class. Okay. Now I sold a lot of beauty products this week, so just bear with me because I know it's kind of boring for some of you, but this is Baronessa Cali Turaco Silicon Blood Orange Foot Cream sealed. There it is. It's still sealed. You can see that there. Sold for $8.50, free shipping. This was teeny tiny. It's just 2.5 fluid ounces. You can see how small it. No. Oh, yeah. Okay. It was 2.5 fluid ounces. You can see that the bottle was about 5 inches tall. Something that I had got in one of my many beauty boxes that I do get. I keep a lot of the things, but the things that I know I won't use, I'll just put them up on eBay. $8.50, free shipping. It did ship first class. Here is another Hot Wheel. And again, you can see the condition isn't the greatest. You know, it's been played with. And this was from 1983. And underneath here, like I was saying, you can see here, it'll say Hot Wheels, 40 Ford two-door, Mattel, 1983. So you can get all of this information on the bottom of the car, and you can just put that in as your search. Sold for $21.73 with free shipping. It did ship first class. Like I said, I'm trying a little bit of an experiment with shipping some first class items free. It's been doing pretty well, though. I have to admit, I'm pretty happy with it so far. The next item is Clear Skin Club Clean Slate Clearing Mist. Sealed, another, this was another beauty subscription box item. This sold for $14. I did do free shipping. It did ship first class. Another beauty item here, Earth Harbor Marina Biome Brightening Empoil, 1 fluid ounce anti-aging vegan soy, new in the box. There she is. Sold for $12. I think I had it for $15. Took a best offer of $12. Free shipping. It shipped first class. Another beauty item. This is pretty pop. Probiotic Power Whipped Cream from Saturday Skin. I do know that Saturday Skin is a pretty popular brand of beauty product items. So this sold for $19.99 with free shipping. And it went to a subscriber. So thank you. Thank you so much. This is the item that I just pulled today. It was this Corsic, this, whatever this word is, I can't say it. Pro, I can't say that word either. Light Ampoule, dermatologist tested, new, sealed, sold for $16 with free shipping. It did ship first class. Ooh, here's the Black Star Villain. This is Filmation Overlord. Laser light chest. And the laser light in his chest did work. Isn't he lovely? This is that John Blackstar guy. Sold for $28. I had a lot of interest in this when I listed it. And, you know, I will say, too, to save time, you can see these pictures aren't as bright. I typically will just go in and just highlight and brighten the main photo. And you can do that if you're on your laptop. You can't do it when you're listing things on your phone. You can make your drafts on your phone and then go in to the eBay photo tool and, you know, brighten it up a little bit. And I did do that and it did work. But just to save time, I just did it on the cover photo. Oh, you know what? And he did ship free. Yeah, free shipping on him. Oh my gosh, isn't this the cutest thing ever? Let's just look at it for a minute. Look how cute. Now, it is played with. You can see. This is from 1965. This is a Lesney, which is, he was the Matchbox Cars creator. And this was a number 23 trailer caravan. It was made in England, like most the Lesney cars are. You can see, again, love that Matchbox and Hot Wheels did this. It makes it so nice for those of us that are reselling things to just type in all that information when we're trying to look up comps. This, I don't even know where we got this from. Probably Mark got it in a bag full of other cars that he buys. It did sell very, very fast. Within 24 hours of me listing this for $12, free shipping, it shipped first class. Next, we have another Christmas ornament. Now, this was a Hallmark keepsake. Here's Daffy Duck. Look at Daffy. It did have a paperwork card with it, and it sold. It was an open box. It had all of the stuff on the inside, and it sold for $15 with free shipping, shipped first class. Next, we have a longer burger basket. I actually got this a long time ago. It's been sitting in a bin for a while from the bins, believe it or not. I did. I picked this up from the Goodwill outlet. It is a longer burger basket. It is the wall hanging basket from 2005. It's funny because I had this and I sent out several best offers, I think for $25, and people denied it. And like within just a few minutes of me sending out another offer to somebody, they denied it for $25, and then someone came in and bought it at full asking price of $28. So you just never know. Sometimes it's just the person that sees it that day that decides that today's the day that we're going to get it. And so for $28, I did charge shipping on this because it was over a pound, and it went out to priority mail. Fit in a 12 by 12 by 8 box perfectly and went out to the new buyer. This was something that sold very quickly as well. I have another one of these listed, so I don't know what made this one sell. They're exactly the same. This is some restaurant ware from Indiana University. I picked this up for 99 cents for the mug, 99 cents for the saucer. Sold for $22. I believe I had it originally listed for $25. This shipped really nicely in a 7x7x6 USPS box. The buyer did pay shipping. And sold for $22 with the best offer, sold within 24 hours of me listing it. This is an Apple iPod Nano, fifth generation, the green. And it was tested and it works. You can see here, we put a like a darkened picture of the screen being on so the buyer can see that it does work. I did have this listed for 60. I believe I had it listed for 70, took a best offer of 60. This is something that I have literally had sitting in a bin for probably 3 years. We picked it up at a yard sale for a couple dollars about 3-4 years ago. And it was just money in an opportunity pile. So we just opened up that tub and started taking some pictures and listing some things. Sold within 24 hours of me listing it. These older electronics do still sell. So if you have your old Apple Nano iPod floating around and you never use it, sell it. They do sell pretty quickly, especially if the condition is really nice and they do work. This had no charging cord. It had no headphones. You can see here in the listing, does not come with charger or headphones. Get those things listed if they're just sitting in a closet. Oh, next we've got this guy. Action Hero figures do sell pretty well. This was another one of my son's items that, you know, he had ample opportunity to list it, make the money. He chose not to, so we did. And he's learned a valuable lesson from that. But this is McFarlane Toys. Halo Reach series, the Spartan gun, maybe that's spelled wrong. I don't know. With his rocket launcher. Isn't he tough? He's tough. Now, he is just a little, what was his item specifics down here? Yeah, a scale 112. So he wasn't that big. He had his markings there on his foot. I think I had him listed for 28, took a best offer of 25, and we did charge shipping on this. So there you go. Sometimes some of them I didn't get edited, and this was one of them, sold for $25, buyer paid shipping. This is something that I've had for probably 7-8 years. Literally, I promise you I've had it forever, but I didn't have free shipping on it. So I ended the listing and I relisted it and I added free shipping and it sold within a couple days. This is a cool little vintage train engineer cap, sold for, there it is. It's from the Cogwheel Route, Pikes Peak Railway. Sold for $12. I think I had it for $15. Sold for $12.50. It did ship first class and took a best offer of it. This was another little beauty product, Persona. It's still sealed in the package. It is a eyeliner, sold for $6.90, free shipping. This was something, again, that came in a beauty box. It just cost me under $3 to ship it. Next, we have a 2002. I've had this for several years as well. Hallmark keepsake ornament, Holly Hill, first in the series, which is something, you know, look for items that say whatever in the series. That's just your cue to kind of look up comps to see if it is worth picking up. So for $14, it did ship first class, and this is the first in the series, but you can see on the box here, it had these other little bears. So that was the complete set. So this was a piece that maybe somebody needed because they had all the bears, but they didn't have this one. So that's one thing that I look at when I'm looking at ornaments. And then we have the last thing is this Yenza Pumpkin Termic Polishing Mask. And again, another beauty box item that I wasn't going to use. Sold for $12 with free shipping. And then I wanted to pull up this. So I couldn't pull up my weekly sales. So I just decided, let's just pull up the report to see what we've done so far this year, which is just basically it's under a month. So again, I'm a part-time eBay seller. My total sales this week, or this from January 1st to January 26th, which is today, total sales $2,589.65, up quite a bit from the prior time period because I really wasn't listing much anyway. Taxes and fees, so eBay does take out sales tax. That's what these, and then that's what this number is. Selling costs. I get a lot of people that ask me, what are the selling costs? That's basically, like, I promote all of my listings 2% if I'm running any kind of promotions or sales. That is where that is taken out of. So that's what those fees are. And you can see eBay's fees, the amount you paid to shipping. Oh, this is also shipping. I'm sorry. This is also shipping. So all of the free shipping that I have done or any of the shipping that I have had to pay for. That's what this number is right here. And then this is the net sales. So this is the amount that eBay had put into my my account. And that was $1,520.26 for the month of January, with just a few days left. But since my weekly report was not working correctly for me, I just wanted to go ahead and pull this up. You can find this easily if you go into your performance, and then you go into your sales like that. And then you can go and you can just pull up on this toggle what you want to see for the year. You can also do custom. So you can just put in what days that you want down here and you can pull up your numbers that way.
Okay, guys. So those are the things that sold for me this past week on eBay. I'm so sorry that the thing was all messed up, but I wanted to go ahead and at least show you the things that, I guess, my numbers for the month. You know, again, I'm a part-time eBay seller. So the more that you list, the more that you sell. And I just haven't listed a lot this week. So I'm hoping that that will improve next week. I don't know. We'll see. But I don't know. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure that you give it a thumbs up. I want to just say thank you so much for all of the comments telling me that you do like these videos and that they are helpful. It's always my hope that I can at least help in some way. If you have a question about something, you put it in the comments and I will do my best to answer it. Thank you again so much for watching and following me and all of the support. I just want to say thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I really, really appreciate it. Make sure that if you are not, you're subscribed to my channel. I do live sales every week here on my YouTube channel. Also, make sure that you're following me on Facebook. I will be doing some little pop-up sales exclusively on Facebook only. So make sure that you are following me on there as well. The link is down in the description below. And as always, here on YouTube, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Bye, guys. Red hot mama, red hot mama, you're the one we need. Red hot mama, some charmer, yes indeed. You say that I should be in the Follies, hot tamales. You say that I got a pair of eyes just like old Svengali's. I confess that I possess them.